Y'all, welcome back to another video game review video. I'm your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. With this video, I'm reviewing an NBA game that came out when it was the year 2013, and this game is called NBA 2K13. This game is fun, and Jay-Z is the executive producer, and I really like that you get to play like to 1 to 4 players up in this video game. They got all the basketball teams such as Miami Heat, Los Angeles Lakers, Chicago Bulls, Milwaukee Bucks, and among more. And it's good that Jay-Z produced this video game over the soundtrack, and the video game presents elements and overwhelm styles of the game. Impressive gameplay featuring the control stick on the control the ball, shoot general shots and signature skills, and much more. And you also can build your own player in this video game and build up a career mode. And I'm gonna play a few levels of this game for you all, showing you guys like how fun this game is, and I'm glad that I got a chance to play this game when it was 2014. So here we go, guys. I hope y'all enjoy me playing a few levels of NBA 2K13 for you all.
Introducing the control stick, new for NBA 2K13. The control stick makes it easy to perform dribble moves like crossovers, spins, hesitations, and more with just a flick of the stick. And when it's time to take your shot, just hold down the modifier button and move the stick to shoot jumpers, layups, and throw down monster dunks. Performing more complex gestures with the control stick will allow you to pull off amazing dribble combinations and an entire arsenal of new shot types.
To the next one. here's a shot earlier of the 76ers preparing for action. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Hello, everyone. Great to have you with us. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kinlaw and Steve Kerr. We've got the Milwaukee Bucks and the Philadelphia 76ers. Jim, moments away, and State Farm presents the starting lineups. You guys taking a look at George McGinnis. What will we see from him?
Kevin, he's one of the best finishers we've got in this league. I mean, he rarely misses an opportunity to score inside when he has position.
Quite honestly, he is their muscle. I mean, the guy they rely on for some brute force when they need it is him. Finesse isn't the first word that comes to mind when you're talking about this guy. So Philadelphia will get the first possession. And here's Bibby on the pass to McGinnis. Bryant up top. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Bibby against Jennings. Up at six. The shot by Dawkins is no good.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up that.
Blocked. Here's Collins. Pass to Dawkins. Feet to Bibby. Second chance effort. That's another one. And the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line. It's on Monte Ellis. The 76ers shooting their first free throws of the game.
Fouls called against him, but he gets all ball a lot, too.
Looking at who's out there now for the Bucks. Drew Gooden has checked in for Dellenberg. It's Dunleavy in for Mbala.
it under. Dishes it to Ellis. That doesn't go either for Ellis. The 76ers leading by four. Bibby passes to Dawkins. Outside Bryant. Bibby, he's guarded by Jennings. Bibby kicks to Bryant. He feeds it to Collins. Just five on the clock. The 76ers need to get off a shot. Milwaukee with the rebound. Here's Ellis. And it's rejected. With some changes. Catchings is checked in for Dawkins. Mix comes in for Bryant. And Free subbed in for Bibby. Udo's checked in for the Bucks. Rudrick comes in for Monte Ellis. That was good.
You just can't let him get that close to the hoop.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Jennings kicks to Gooden. They set the pick. Rudrick.
They are setting the tone here early with the work on the boards.
And only a moderate advantage here, slightly, but as the game wears on, it's one they'll definitely look to build on.
Bucks trail by six. Here's Jennings. And he can't stop this drought. Another miss. About 7 seconds up in the shot and game clocks. Three passes to Mitch. It's stolen by Udo. Jennings drives in. That's Free with the rebound.
How often have we seen him break all over a shooter like that, guys?
More than a few times. Well, he has the ability to impact the game with his defense. There's no question about that.
And here's Jennings outside. And he beat the buzzer. But it's no good. And that does it for the first quarter. 76ers lead by six. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. 76ers on top, up by six.
The defense has been key in building this lead. They've really clamped down hard.
They've done a nice job, Steve. I think challenging every shot. A hand up on every shot.
Bibby is out there with Free. And there's Bryant. And it's McGinnis. And it's Kitchings in at the pivot spot, manning the man. That's the group in the game for the 76ers. The 76ers leading by four. The pass to McGinnis.
Like
way he attacks and finishes. I mean, he's about 6'3", maybe 180 lbs, but still able to go inside again and again. Just a tremendous athlete.
And Kevin, keep an eye tonight on how many plays he keeps alive for his club. Just the way he works, the way he moves, the way he anticipates plays before they happen. Constantly looking to get an offensive group.
We also would have to label him the human eraser, Steve.
Third quarter. Now, for presented by Sprint.
Welcome to 2K Sports. It's been a great Sunday of basketball so far. It's been the 76ers scrapping it out. They're an up-tempo team, and the ponies are running. The advantage in fast break points is obvious. No surprise here. Daryl Dawkins with a nice boost. Everything's finding its way through the rim, and he's been filling it up early. And on the other side, Milwaukee just keeps scrapping. Second chance points, a major key so far. They've been the first to the ball whenever there's a missed shot. The leading scorer, Monte Ellis. At the break, 7 points, and also helped out with 2 rebounds. That'll be it for the halftime report. The second half is coming right up. Hope to see you next time.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half.
Take a look at what Ellis has done so far. He's got 7 points, and he's still working hard for those rebounds.
Well, that's what he has to do. Solid effort on the glass can be the difference between winning and losing a lot of nights, guys.
Setting the floor for the Bucks, Ilya Sova and Gallagher are down low. Brandon Jennings and Monte Ellis comprise the backcourt. And it's Mbah Moute in at the threesome.
Very poor shot selection there, guys.
The 76ers leading by 3. There's a screen. Bibby passes to McGinnis. Mahamute with the steal. And up the court come the Bucks on the break. Rebound by the 76ers. Bryant's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Collins passes it to Dawkins. And the rebound goes to D'Alembert. Bucks trail by 3. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Horace Moore. Horace, over to you.
Ellis, last season, the person Scott Skiles took over as head coach of Milwaukee, but the Bucks were not in the top half of the league in defensive efficiency. Coach Skiles is looking to turn that back around. He talked about his defensive philosophy. He said, look, the perimeter players in this league are very gifted with the ball, and almost all of them are great athletes. So you've got to be on. You've got to be competitive and stay in a stance. The footwork has to be impeccable. What we challenge our guys to do from the first day of camp is guard your guy with 3 dribbles. If you can do that, we'll get the help there. Kevin, sounds simple, not easy to execute.
Well, Coach Skiles always challenges his team's defensively. Thanks, boys.
That was an important bucket. They're only 1 of 5 now, so they really had to get their offense quicker.
The 76ers shooting their fourth shot at the foul line here. A different look for Milwaukee. Drew Gooden has checked in for D'Alembert. Udo comes in for Ilya Sova. Dunleavy in for Mbah Moute.
And the offense continues to struggle. Just one make in their 5 attempts.
14 feet away. Outside Jennings. He kicks it to Ellis. Comes in for McGinnis. Steve and Freeze sub in for Collins. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Dunleavy dishes to Ellis. Over Bryant. Ellis can't get it to go.
Boy, rough start to the second half. 5 straight punt.
Gooden with the rebound. Bucks trail by 5. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Here's Bibby. He dishes it to Bryant. Back to Bibby. Feeds it to Bryant. To the middle. Here's Mix. Drilled from 11 feet out. And the 76ers lead by 5.
3 straight buckets in the paint. They're making it look effortless.
Well, speaking of effortless, you'd like to see a little more out of the defense. Well, how about trying, guys?
Now here's Jennings. Shot clock at 6. Here's Ellis. Again, the miss by Ellis.
Not a bad look at the hoop. Just couldn't get it to bounce in for him.
And pass it to 3. To Mix. Buries it down low. And it's a 7-point 76ers lead.
Nice touch near the hoop.
And Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game.
He's been aggressive looking for a shot, but without much.
trick in for Brandon Jennings. Here's Dunleavy. Here's Utrecht. Over World B3, and Utrecht gets it to go.
I'll tell you what, he's made more than a few of those in his career.
The 76ers leading by 5. Here's Free. Pass to Dawkins. That's good. Dawkins has got 4 points now in the fourth. 59 seconds left to play in the third. Now Utrecht. He passes to Bogut. The feed now to Utrecht. They set the pick. Knocked away. Just find the shoot. He'll place jumper from the free throw line. Utrecht has got his second bucket tonight. Utrecht has gotten two of his three shots to go tonight. There's 31 seconds left to play here in the third. Three passes to McGinnis. And blocked. Here's Dunleavy. He's guarded by Collins. And Dunleavy gets it to go in.
And now 6 of their last 10 points from mid-range. Yeah, jump shot really serving these guys pretty well.
Here's Free. Kicks it to Dunleavy. Play and the jumper's good. And the 76ers lead by 4. And we've got 3 so far in this one. 76ers. Quarter getting going here. It's time for the Sprite Uncontainable Game. Doris Burke with the report. Hi, Doris.
Well, for the 76ers, it's been an uncontainable game from their backup power forward. Coming off the bench, he has been just the kind of energy his team needed and given the starters a run for their money in production.
Thank you, Doris. And it's almost that secret ingredient we've seen here tonight. He gave them a big-time boost when they needed it.
Yeah, something lit a fire under, obviously, because as soon as he came in the game, he had a major impact. Maybe he's campaigning for a job in the starting lineup, but either way, he's really something. Guys, it remains to be seen whether or not he can keep this up going forward, but clearly he's shown the capability of having big performances.
They've got Bryant. Hopkins is out there with McGinnis. Then it's Collins, and it's Bibby in at the one. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Ellis can't get it to go.
He's playing selfishly now, guys. He's just trying to get as many shots up as he can. Doesn't look at all concerned about his teammates.
Now, here is Bibby. Passes it to McGinnis. Jennings with the double team. And McGinnis kicks to Bibby. Shot clock at 5. Shoots over Jennings. Bibby with the bucket. Bibby's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the 76ers. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Here's Ellis. It's hauled in by McGinnis. McGinnis has got his second rebound here tonight.
It really hurt him with his performance here. He just hasn't played up to his standards so far.
Collins kicks to Bibby. Free.
pass to McGinnis. Ilyasova on him. Jennings with the double team. Free against Jennings. McGinnis the pass to Free. Jennings with the rebound.
Well, he won't miss many of those.
And the shot is good. And 12 points for Ellis. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here, we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Bibby with it. He passes to McGinnis.
Screen, maybe with it, picked up by Ellis. Five on the clock. Here's Collins. 13
mid-range shots, and he can open up the whole game.
And the 76ers call time here. What do you think, guys?
They barely have enough time to catch the ball and shoot it before time runs out. They can make the shot, they win. If they miss, game over.